叮叮。
Het Greenpoint Stadium in Kaapstad, Zuid-Afrika. Op 24 juni speelt Oranje hier tegen Kameroen. In de grootste show op aarde, het WK voetbal. Maar hoe is het om op te groeien in de schaduw van het stadion? Een half uurtje hier vandaan ligt de beruchte gangsterwijk Hanover Park. In dit kleurlinge ghetto woeden al 20 jaar oorlogen tussen bendes als The Americans en de ghetto's. De grote vraag voor de kinderen die er opgroeien is: hoe blijf ik uit de greep van die gangs? In Joris en de jonge helden van Zuid-Afrika stort ik mij in het leven van 5 prachtkinderen uit Hanover Park. Vandaag de eerste helft. In de schaduw van het stadion.
Dit is fighting hier en shooting kan. Step each other, helping each other. If you play on the field, then you must run. If you just see a police van, then you must know that they rob someone or they stab someone. Then you must come off from the field, then you must go home. And then you can't play soccer for 3 days. And then I'm sad and then I'm crying here in my room.
Rida woont bij zijn opa en oma in een flat midden in Hanover Park. Zijn ouders kunnen niet voor hem zorgen. Voetballen is zijn lust en zijn leven.
This is your room.
Yes.
Oh. Who's that?
It's my cousin's child.
Ah, oh, it's your cousin's child. So what's your bed?
This one.
And who's sleeping there?
My cousin.
And can you go out at night? In the evenings or something, when it's dark outside, can you go play?
No. There's no light here, and it's dangerous in the night for us just to play on the pitches and stuff.
Oh, yeah. What's so dangerous?
The gangsters, they're walking around, they rob the people.
All the
time? They stab the people, yes.
Do you hear things like that? Explosions or something? I don't know.
No.
What do you hear? Shots? Gunshots? Yes. Do you know people? Do you have friends who joined a gang? Yeah?
Like Luciano.
He was in a gang. And you knew him very well.
Yes.
Why did he join this gang? Do you know that?
His friends.
His friends?
Yes.
Persuaded
his
him
to. Bad influence for him.
Oh, yeah. So what is it?
He stabbed him.
They stabbed him?
Yes.
Did you see it?
No. It was in the school time.
And do you know why they did that?
It's gang fights.
Oh. Do you know the reason why?
It's like they throw stones to each other. And it become a big thing and so they stab him.
And what does that feel like for you? That this happens in your neighborhood, in your own street?
Sad for me to hear he's dead, and he was also a soccer player.
So, do you have friends with bad influence, or do you try to keep them away? I don't know.
No, I just play with. I'm younger than me, then I play with them like soccer and running around here in the court, chasing each other.
I understand. But I also understand that in this neighborhood, it's difficult to grow up because when you get older, the gangs will come and try to convince you to join them. Are you afraid of that?
Yes.
And how can you defend yourself?
I can't defend myself because they're riding with cars, and they call you, and then they how can I say, and they kidnap you. And then they ask you to be in the gang. If you don't want to be in the gang, then they stab you dead. Or they go right far with you, then they just drop you dead. You must find your own way home.
So in a way, when you were 16 years old or something, there's no other option than going with a gang? than be in a gang? No? What's the other option then?
To play soccer. And how can I say it? Just be happy. If you're happy, then the people can say, look, there's that boy. He's never sad or like that. He's always happy.
So that's the best defense, being happy. And do you feel happy?
Yes.
Good for you. Ryan woont in het relatief rustige township Smallville, ver weg van het geweld van Hanover Park. Als hij niet aan het voetballen is, verdient hij wat bij door op de koeien van een buurman te passen. Hallo.
Goedemorgen. Goedemorgen.
So Ryan, you always work here during the Saturday.
Yes.
And what do you do?
Watch the cows.
Watch the cows.
Yeah, and William.
It's your friend William. And do you live here and this is your house?
Yes.
That's a long way from school.
Yes.
So how do you go to school?
Walk.
You walk? Seems to be very far.
Walk.
How much time does it take to go to school then?
Hour.
1 hour? Do you walk all by yourself?
No, me, my mommy.
Oh, your mother's... So that's a big family. Everybody's living here. You have 2 sisters?
3 sisters.
3 sisters?
Yes.
Do you also have brothers?
2 brothers.
2 brothers? And where are they?
One brother in jail.
In jail?
And the other one lives in Krasnopol.
How old is he?
27.
And he's in jail?
Yeah.
Why is he in jail?
His cousin robbed the man of his cell phone, and he took it the blame on himself.
So he didn't do anything?
No, he didn't do anything. He took 2 years. I was in prison for 2 years.
And he's innocent, you say?
Yeah, he's innocent.
Weren't you afraid that they would join a gang or something?
He was in a gang.
He was in a gang?
Yes, Americans.
But that's a very tough gang.
Yeah, he was in a gang. They made him a gangster.
He didn't want to, but they made him a gangster.
He didn't want to be a gangster.
How do they do that?
They were cutting
him. It's like a tattoo.
They put a tattoo in his arm.
Oh, they made a tattoo?
Yes.
And a brand mark?
Yes, and he must belong to them. He was 17 years old, or 10 years. So very young.
So they took him and made this tattoo, and then he was a member. He couldn't refuse.
He couldn't refuse, yes.
Not what crying. Would have happened if he should have
killed him?
Okay.
They threatened him.
So he was in a gang?
He was in a gang.
So what did he do? What kind of things do people in gangs?
They must go rob, then they must go steal and kill some people.
So he is not that innocent?
Yeah. No. He's not actually that innocent, but he didn't kill somebody yet. Asked him how many times, but they robbed and they steal and they do whatever they feel like to them. I was never there for him.
No, but there is a chance that a gang could come and take Ryan as well?
No.
Why not?
I'm very protective.
You'll see to it. And that's why he's staying here and not in Hanover Park.
Very, very. Yes,
you don't have gangsters over here?
No, no gangsters here.
No gangs. No gangsters.
They say something they say in Hanover Park. They say you love by the gun and you die by the gun.
Een van de meest opvallende figuren in Hanover Park is Rashida. Elke dag is ze bezig met het coachen van de kinderen in haar wijk. Voor haar is sport het wapen in de strijd voor een veilige omgeving.
Everything starts with the drugs, the glue. Glue you can buy at the shops. Then they sniff the glue. And if a child is under the influence of those drugs, he will do anything. And that is where everything starts. Because now, if I'm the gang boss and I want something to be done, and merely because that is a child, I'm going to use him. Mm-hmm. Because at the end of the day, if he gets caught, they won't punish him because he's still a child.
So what do they force these children to do then?
Just shoot. So it's child killing a child.
What is your big dream?
I want to go live in England. That's my dream. My mommy, my family.
And leave South Africa. Why is that?
This place is not good for me.
No? Why?
I'm afraid that they're gonna stab me here.
You'd better go to England then. It's safe over there. And how could you do that? Move to England?
First, achieve a girl here in South Africa.
Yeah, which goal?
To run.
So you become a famous runner in South Africa and then move to England? An international sports career?
Yes.
To get away from the gangs?
Yes.
On your mark.
Go! Come, Atiki, you can do it, boy, you can do it. Come, Atiki, you can do it, come on, boy, come on. Come on, boy, you can do it, come on. Beat that time, come on, Tiki. Come on, come on, come on. 12 seconds. Well done, boy, well done. Go. Come on, boy, focus, focus, focus. That's the fair, focus, focus, that's the fair. Beat the record, beat the record. Pick it up, come on. Run, run, run. 11 seconds. Well done.
So you are living with your grandma and grandpa and your mother, who's always at the hospital?
Yes.
What about your father?
My father isn't staying here. And he's also on drugs, so we don't see him.
And how's that to you?
If I don't see my dad, then it's for me, like, don't having a dad here. And my mother must be the mom and the dad here in the house.
So do you miss him?
Yes.
And what do you miss?
He did play with me when I was young, and he did talk with me. So I miss that from him.
Can you understand why he's doing this?
No.
And when you see him, does he tell you nice things? Does he call you nice names?
No, he don't talk with me.
Do you think he will ever quit taking drugs and come back to the family?
I don't know.
Would you still receive him with open arms?
No.
Are you angry? So who are living here in this house?
It's me. I'm the grandmother from Ryan.
Mm-hmm.
And this is my great-grandson.
Uh-huh.
And this is my granddaughter's husband.
And Ryan stays here every morning?
Yes.
He's going to come?
He'll come to school.
Yes.
And then wait. When his mother come home, then from work and then he go home.
Must be hard to grow up in such a neighborhood.
Yeah, it's very hard to grow up in such a neighborhood.
Did you grow up here?
Yes.
And are you in drugs or something?
No.
So, why is that? Because most of the youngsters are, well, like gangsters over here.
A few years back, I was also involved, you see, in gangsterism and stuff like that. Yeah. But what I see, that it doesn't give you the benefit. It gives you nothing. In the end of the day, you die for nothing. You see?
But why did you join them? Or did they force you to?
No, they didn't force me. It's almost like a sense of belonging. You see? A sense of belonging, you belong to these people.
You belong to a group. You feel safe in a group. Something
yeah, something like that, yeah. But what happened is, most of the parents, they start drinking, you see. Mm-hmm. And when a father figure start drinking, you see, then it's very hard and difficult.
Because
you cannot
example.
Run to, yeah, you cannot run to your father, tell daddy, I need this, I want this and that, you see. And if father chases you away, and gangs like this, they go to you, what you need, this and that, and they give you.
Then so the gang is the father figure?
Almost like that, yeah.
Keep the breathing going, keep the breathing going. Keep the breathing going. Our is next to our...
So do you think Ryan has got the power to stay away from these gangs?
He must involve himself in stuff like the soccer and negative things. He needs love. He needs someone to care for him. I mean, what I'm trying to say, it is possible for him to go further in life with doing sports. This is what must happen to our children. They must see that there's a potential. You see, if you have that kind of spirit, I can do it.
Well done. Well done, Ryan. Well done. Over there, over there. Over there.
Kevin, pass to Kevin.
Mario is sportcoach op de school van Rida en Ryan. Ook na schooltijd geeft Mario sportlessen, zodat de kinderen niet de hele tijd op straat hoeven te hangen. Achter de hoge hekken kunnen ze zich helemaal vrij voelen.
Soccer is like a tool. Yeah. The kids use like on schools everywhere. To keep away from drugs and gangsterism. Like we say, a child in sport is a child away from court.
I saw you coaching Ryan. What about Ryan? He's a big runner, this small guy, huh?
Yeah, like they say, dynamite come in small packages. That's very good. So I was also like a long distance runner when I was at school. So I know how to motivate him and keep him going. And also like, and he gives me hope and the person that he is now isn't the person that he was like a few months ago. So I can see there's big growth in his attitude in class, in the home. I saw him like playing there with the kids and now he got more, he's like he's open-minded now. And the friends that he have now isn't the same friends that they have in the beginning.
Oh yeah, that's important. What about Rida? He's also a big sportsman, soccer player.
Yeah, Rida, I noticed something about him.
What?
When he's stressing at home. I can see different times, his facial expressions. There was lots of the days he was complaining, and afterwards, when we ran, like the first time into schools, he was like one of the good runners. And his attitude changed drastic. It changed like in a good way. That guy got a good attitude. The attitude with me, towards me, mm-hmm. as a coach changed. And also the attitude at school.
What do you feel in your heart when you see these children of yours playing soccer and having fun? What do you feel?
It's always, my heart is blooming to see a child smile because you take them their minds away from drugs. You take their minds away from all these wrong stuff that they do.
Goal!
But simply as close to challenge.
So what about the spirit of the people here in Hanover Park? Do they still have it? Can they survive all these problems?
Yes, the actual thing here in the area is that the people are in denial, man. And because they're in denial, the violence is growing. If you go to a person that is in drugs, or you must show that person that, yes, I believe in you, you're a human. Those are the kind of things you must give that person hope. You must give them, you're still alive. So be alive and love your life. Don't sit there, you drag and you just don't care. Then you're living dead. It doesn't pay to be a gangster. Ek hoor wat jy sê. Dan kyk jy rondom jou na almal die kindertjies.
What's going on?
Now he's talking about his life and his life of gangsterism and what he sees can be done. So you can talk to him.
Something nice that you the program that you bring up for the children, something nice for me. Because why for 20 years I am American here. I the king from behind the place. I shoot the people. But today I see him and my eyes go open. He doesn't push.
But why did you do it? Why? You were shooting at people. Why?
I don't know. For me, it was something nice. Man. You see, to have a gun in your hand, it makes you must be great. Beat me. Every day. Every day. I fucking stand with a fucking 16 shooter here in my mouth. You don't talk cock with me. I say bang, 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 bang. It's not something nice, man.
And did you kill people as well?
I did kill also people. People, they want to kill me. Like you can see here, they shoot my fucking whole leg.
There's been a bullet.
Get the bullet, whole leg.
And what can you do now to help these children, that they won't go into the game?
It's only with sports. That's the only thing.
You really mean that sports? Because it's such a tiny thing against all that violence.
That's all that I want them to grow up here in the place. I don't want them to be gangsters one day. Because why to be a gangster doesn't pay me. Look like Benny McCarthy, he was staying here on the corner.
The big Ajax player.
Growing up with that life thing.
So do you regret that period? Or are you proud of it?
I'm not proud of it.
I'm not proud of it.
No, I'm not proud of it. Because when now I am 35 years old, I can see him and yeah, that is not something nice for me. Like I'm getting older. I want to take my head out of it, but I cannot.
And is this your son?
Yes, that is my son. Then.
What, when he turns 16, are you afraid that he's going to join a gang?
I'm afraid. That's why he told.
And what can you do to provide that? What can you do that he will not go into this gang?
To put him in a school, he must learn out of it. That's the only thing I can tell you.
And do you think he will manage?
Yes, he will manage because why he is speaking English. You know, I learned him with English. He's growing up with English, that like it. And one day I want to be him. He must be a brave man. Kaji, he must talk about what he done here in this place.
He must be the new Benny McCarthy.
Yes, he must be the new Benny McCarthy. I would like him to be the new Benny McCarthy. But I didn't join me now with you, man. I'm going on my thing now. You see?
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Sir.
So what about your dreams? What are your dreams?
I'd like to be a famous soccer player. And the people must cheer for me. And I just want to show the people here out in Nova Park, you can come good.
Do you think your dreams will come true?
Yes.
And now we walk on through, just like the real players, into the players' tunnel. Looking at the pitch, 68,000 people cheering loud for Rita and Ryan. What do you think, Rita?
It's big.
It's bigger. Shall we touch the holy grass? This is forbidden, of course. Real soft, huh? Look how flat it is. To smell the grass. Oh. That's good, huh?
Stronger, they'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. They say, the struggle is fighting to eat,
I believe a child in sport is a child out of court. I believe in that. It's like a wave in